Hello everyone, long time no see. I've been super busy just getting my act together really. But my name's Rosie Jenner, welcome to my channel, welcome back to my channel. If you're watching this, you probably know me because I'm a sad sack. But yeah, welcome back. Today I'm going to be talking about borderline personality disorders and relationships. I thought, what a better way to do a video than when I'm already ready for a date. So I look peng and actually feel like I want to do a video. Also, I'm sorry, I'm looking at myself. So it's a video I've been meaning to do for a long time. I didn't think I'd be making this video. I thought it'd just be on relationships, but it's gonna be on heartbreak too. Get that out of the way, but I think it's a really important topic to go through and just talk about because, you know, it is a fact of life. Unfortunately, it happens a lot. We all go through heartbreak, we all go through our romances, and I just thought it would be important to just make a video on it, especially because it feels relevant to my life right now. So I'm going to start with obviously what I learned while I was in a long relationship. We were together for 2 years. It was hard. It was when I was going through the worst time in my mental health and when I actually discovered that I had BPD. So it's just sort of me talking about my experiences. I don't want to like discredit anyone's experiences. I don't want to like go against what therapists are saying, but this is personally my experience. It is based on research and what I know about BPD and obviously everything that I've learned through. Disclaimer, I do research. I'm a psychology student. I'm aiming to be a clinical psychologist, all of that. But obviously I'm not qualified, so I've got to put a disclaimer. But this is how I coped in a relationship and how I coped with heartbreak while being BPD. So this is sort of like a two-section video. If it's too long, I might split it, but let's get into it. So the most important thing that I ever learned being in a relationship with BPD is that you have to have boundaries, which is really hard. And boundaries being that because BPD is so centered around relationships and because relationships are so important to the elements of your paranoia and anxiety, literally every area of BPD really revolves around relationships. That's sort of like the defining factor apart from impulsivity to do with this personality disorder. So it's important to make sure that you're always nurturing your relationships because obviously it's a big part of your life and you're going to react a lot more in a higher emotion than most people are. So boundaries are really important, and by that I mean do not become codependent. If you are relying on your partner to make sure that you're okay and to look after you and basically be your therapist, it's going to be unhealthy, it's going to put stress on them, it's going to get stress on you, and whenever they try to help you and can't, it's going to break down the relationship. And it's just gonna make it harder in the long run because you can't. A relationship is like a child. It's sort of a separate part of you which you both put into and you both take out of, but it does have to be a sort of separate part of you. In counseling, one of the biggest rules is that you can never counsel your own family members. You cannot work with people you know because it's just not effective. And there's just so many emotions involved, especially when, you know, you have those relationship talks, but for someone with BPD, it's really hard. So taking a step back and not being in your emotions and saying, look, this is what about our relationship is scaring me. It's hard to do. And honestly, getting your own mental health space and being out of your head and setting those boundaries not to let them become your carer, setting those boundaries not to be around them all the time, setting those boundaries to challenge yourself and do CBT, like challenge your anxieties, challenge your paranoia, really, really helps. And that's the biggest thing that I could possibly share with you guys about relationships and BPD. Another thing is that, honestly, I didn't believe it for years and years. I didn't believe it. That you do have to love yourself before you love anyone else. I learned it the hard way. A huge part of my relationship was my paranoia, me not really knowing what was going on and not being able to communicate effectively. I was always up in my emotions. I was always really scared. And if you're able just to breathe and get on with it and love yourself, I can't even describe. Like, this whole break, me being away from all of this, has basically been me trying to love myself, and It works wonders. You will never be scared if you value yourself. You will never have that paranoia. You won't be anxious. You won't be like just doubting every second of your waking life because you know that you're enough. And if it goes wrong, you have yourself and you're amazing and you know that. And you know that you can get through it because you are strong and you are brave and you know that now. But if it goes south and you don't know that, or it goes south because you never did, it really does affect relationships. I'm sure we all have those weird realizations where, you know, we go throughout our teen lives and we're like, oh my gosh, like everyone's saying I should love myself first, it's so bollocks. And then you'll have a relationship, especially if you have BPD, and you'll realize how much self-loathing really does impact a relationship, like a lot. And it causes trust issues, it causes high emotions all the time and not the good ones. And it's just best to obviously put those boundaries in place, make sure that you're looking after yourself, but also find time to really get to know yourself and really love yourself, because at the end of the day, you know, I don't necessarily believe that we die alone or that we don't have soulmates, but I do believe that at the end of the day you will always have your own back. We are basically vessels just walking around in our own skin with our own thoughts, and at the end of the day you are one person, and if you know yourself and if you really love yourself, then life is just so much easier. I know it sounds really stupid, and I will be doing a video on how I came to love myself, obviously, because this is all a load of bullshit if you don't know what I'm going on about, but it's just something that you have to work on. Work on your own mental health, work on your boundaries, work on your communication. Communication is a huge thing in BPD. I remember days where I would be literally having panic attacks every hour, and as soon as I got that text saying, hey babe, I'm really sorry, I was out all day, hope you're okay, I love you, that confirmation, that, you know, it puts your paranoia to bed. It means that you know they love them, you even. And they're dedicated and they're sorry and they know that they might have upset you, but it's okay because you're allowed to feel like that. And it happens. And just knowing that they're safe, or just knowing that they want to talk to you and let you know where they are, is hugely relieving. At least it was for me. So communication is really important, no matter what it's about. If it's about their emotions, if it's about yours, and that's another huge part of BPD, is that you need to know that you aren't alone. And I know that sounds like so cliche, but you're not alone. And you're also not alone in your feelings. Your partner has feelings too. And if you both manage to work on them together and work on your separate emotions apart and together, then there's really nothing that can go wrong. If you're both in a good headspace, if you're both ready for it, like, it's amazing. So amazing. And unfortunately we don't all get that, but it's important to talk about because it happens, and there's nothing wrong with not being ready. I'm back. So this is gonna be the second part. I'm looking dead as an egg. So my date went really well last night, and then obviously I had work today again. So what better way to introduce the heartbreak sector of this video than by looking heartbrokenly disgusting. So we've covered communication, self-love, regulating your own emotions, and not being alone. I just want to say that a huge part of not being alone is having your own friends, having your own friendship groups, being able to communicate with other people too. Because honestly, nothing has helped me more than having someone else to talk to, having friends to talk to, or a counsellor, or a colleague, or anyone who's going to ask you about your day, so that you're not putting it all on your partner. Because a huge part of relationships is that there is emotions there, and if they're the wrong kind of emotions, it's just going to bring you both down and end in heartbreak. And I just wanted to say, I will maybe be making another video on how to deal with your partner being BPD. This is more of a video for those of you who are BPD and getting into relationships and are worried and just want a few tips. But a huge thing that I should mention if I don't make that video is that education is important. Educating anyone, no matter what relationship it is, whether it's a boyfriend, or a girlfriend, or your mom, or your sister, or your friend, whoever it is, it's so important to educate yourself on what's going on, because the more they know about your disorder, the more they know how you can just work through your own emotions and how you deal with it and what can help, and they can help to advise you and help to make those boundaries or help to just make you feel like you're valid and that they understand what you're going through, because there is nothing better than your partner saying, I understand and it's okay. So that's a really big thing that I think I need to mention. So heartbreak. I got pretty lucky when I got the text saying, yo, let's call this off. I was at work and I took 5 minutes. I was sort of expecting it. I just had a little breather, had a tiny cry and went back to work. And that was enough for me because that's how my relationship was. But it's not that easy for everyone. But having just come back from work and feeling extremely appropriate, work really helps. Distractions really help. For me, it was keeping up a routine. And as someone with BPD, and a huge part of my BPD is OCD symptoms, something that I really struggled with was, oh my god, everything's about to change. I really hate change. I'm scared of change. So having just even little things like having a friend that you can tag in photos, or having a friend that you can, you know, go to and like have a laugh with, or tell your day to, or just ringing them at night, or anything that keeps up that routine but with other people, so that you still feel secure and you can move out of that more gently, is really, really helpful. Because, well, regulation, emotional regulation, does also affect your routine. And you know, you spend so long with someone and you get used to the routine with them, and that's really scary. Also, my lips are disgustingly stained with red wine from last night. But yeah, so having people to go to and having that routine sort of fade away more gently, or just having people that you can substitute, not that you're ever using anyone, but if they're your friends, they'll understand. And yeah, for me, it was just a case of distraction, 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 but it's not that easy always. But just remember that you are allowed to feel like that. You know, breakups are awful and heartbreak is awful, no matter what kind of heartbreak it is. Obviously I'm talking romantic here, but no matter what kind of heartbreak, you have the right, no matter what emotion even, just scrub all that stuff about heartbreak. No matter what you feel, you are valid in feeling it, because you're feeling it. It's not your fault. It's just an emotion is happening. Your head's probably not in the best place, and people are going to understand that because it's crap. And you're allowed to feel like that. And if you want to wallow for a few days, wallow for a few days. But it's so easy just to lie there and do nothing, and then you feel pathetic and stupid, and you just get more depressed because you're not going outside, you're not getting the right food, you're not looking after yourself. And a huge part of self-care, obviously, is taking those basic steps to look after your health and well-being. So if you just manage to maintain and keep going and keep plodding along, and just know that, like, I genuinely was so scared of getting out of a long-term relationship because I thought there would never be anyone again. I thought, I'm never going to be able to trust anyone. No one's ever going to love me like that. I don't know what to do. No one's going to understand. And I was completely wrong. And I was genuinely, genuinely convinced of it. As you do. And especially with those irrational thoughts, it's very easy to think that. And as someone who's been through it, and as someone who got so much advice from people who have been through it, I can definitely 100% say that no matter what irrational thoughts you have about leaving a relationship, whether it's toxic or whether you just need space or it's just coming to its natural end, there is nothing better than knowing that you're valid and knowing that there are people there and knowing that there will be something else. And whether that's loving yourself and having a long-time romance with yourself, a lifelong romance, and just enjoying life and doing what you want and being free, or it's finding someone who's even better, there will always be something for you, I absolutely promise. But obviously it's not easy to just listen to someone and believe them. You have to make your own happiness, and part of that for me was distraction. So I did a lot of art, I did a lot of planting, I went out with friends, I went clubbing, I did everything I had missed out on, and it's really important to do that. So keeping a routine that is sustainable but won't make you feel like you're just replacing that person, because you do need to work through things. But yeah, that's my advice from my perspective of having BPD and going through a heartbreak and relationships and all that. Not that it will help anyone, but hopefully it does. And it's important to talk about, because these things happen. I'm an open book. I'm not just going to be like, yeah, my life's perfect, or yeah, I'm having a meltdown today because of my BPD. Like, we still have situational factors, we still have chemical factors. There are so many things that affect us, and one of those things is relationships, especially with BPD. So I hope that someone out there is being helped by this video, and that, I don't know, comment down below what you did to get through your relationships. If it's eating ice cream and crying to Bridget Jones, I did that for a day, or if it's just powering through and becoming a workaholic. Or just being yourself. There's nothing wrong with doing whatever makes you happy. So I hope you've enjoyed this really weird two-part low-key hype, low-key sad video. But I promise that better things will always be there. And whether that's within your relationship or outside of it, you will be fine. And you just need to know that you are so valid, especially in BPD. There are so many reasons for feeling like that about relationships, or feeling any way about relationships, and it's not your fault. It's never your fault, but it's also not an excuse to just lie around all day and not pick up the pieces, because you need to. And you know, life is still there after that person. You are still here, and you can still love yourself. So, after this sappy note, I really hope that you're all having a good day. I have literal notebooks of ideas for this channel, but unfortunately, I'm lazy and I work. So hopefully I'll get more out. And this is sort of just a welcome back, sort of something that I really wanted to talk about for ages, but didn't know if I'd feel ready enough or if it was disrespectful. There is a fly. But yeah, have a good day, and I will see you next time. Goodbye.